there, my name is Chantelle, and I bought this Etchr sketchbook for the sole purpose of painting movie and TV scenes. Whilst watching TV, I'm going to be looking out for kind of obscure scenes that aren't very common, and they're the ones that I would like to paint. So I hope you enjoy the series. Here's the first one. May the 4th be with you. I was actually planning for my first screen cap painting to be from Harry Potter, but I saw that May the 4th was on a Thursday, my regular posting day, so I feel like it's kind of a sign. Today I chose to paint a scene from The Mandalorian. Season 3 has only just come out and finished, so I'm not going to be revealing any spoilers on here, but I'm going to be painting a scene from The Mandalorian. The show is on Disney Plus, and honestly, I've loved all of the Star Wars series that have come out since, but this one is definitely my favourite. It takes place just after Return of the Jedi and follows a Mandalorian, and obviously introduces some other Mandalorians as the time goes on. And it's a little bit darker and more gritty than the Star Wars films in general. I feel like it definitely is attracting an older audience, but I really enjoyed that because it has less of that kind of comedy aspect that some of the other Star Wars have, and it is definitely for a more mature audience. I definitely recommend it if you haven't seen it already. I do think the third season has been my favourite so far. It was a little bit confusing how each episode, it's like you had to watch the recap to kind of understand each of the characters, because each episode had like a different bad person and they introduced different characters, I feel. The third season definitely seemed to jump about a bit more. It was like every episode was a mini film that had its own storyline. It kind of followed a similar pattern to Andor, actually. In Andor, it's like every single episode was different. And I do like that. I feel like the Star Wars series have just been so interesting, the ones that have come out. And I do really love the format. But it's set in like the Star Wars universe. They're all just slower and have longer to actually develop and build characters. Whilst watching the third season, I did keep an eye out for scenes in every episode, but a lot of them were really, really detailed or had a lot of people in the scenes, and I wanted to go for something a little more simple with my kind of style. There were lots of really stunning scenes, but I just didn't really want to go for a detailed landscape or city or something, just because that's not really what I enjoy. I can appreciate when other artists can do really hyper detailed backgrounds, but I personally just don't enjoy it and I'm not very good at it. I would much rather do a slightly flowy piece. But I did actually struggle with this painting because I knew that I wanted to do movie scenes, but I hadn't quite established how I was going to paint them. So I started with a kind of flowy kind of watercolour, but I somehow managed to pull it together. I'm going to leave you to enjoy the painting process now, and I'll pop back in a little bit.
Thank you.
I know that everyone on social media right now is a little bit obsessed with Pedro Pascal. I've loved him since Game of Thrones, but he is so good in this series too. Whilst I do love this scene that I've chosen, I think something that I really don't have experience with, and it was definitely highlighted here, is I've never paused a scene before. And something that a lot of these scenes tend to have is focusing really on the foreground with like a really blurry background. And that was difficult. And I feel like I probably could have done a bit more of a watercolor effect and made the background blurry, but I'm not sure exactly how I would go about that. And I feel like that would be hard to control. I tried to make the background a little bit more crisp, but it was difficult because when it came to painting, like the background character in the scene, he's just a big blur. But obviously, like, he's the main character. I wanted him to be recognizable. So that was just something that I encountered, really. Also, I did have to simplify the background quite a bit because there was quite a lot of detail, but because the background was blurred, it was really difficult to see what was going on. In the end, I do think I managed to pull it together, though it was definitely a lot more challenging than I thought it would be. I did do some of Grogu off camera. I felt a lot of pressure to try and get him right and do him justice, so I needed to concentrate. And also because he's such a light colour, and I still haven't got myself a buff titanium, I kind of removed it from my favourites because I thought, no, I don't need a white, it's watercolour. But I've seen a lot of people mixing whites into their colours lately, and it just makes a really lovely pastel effect. That buff titanium is going to go back on my favourites if it ever gets reduced and I can treat myself. Because painting Grogu at this size wasn't fun, honestly. I was doing it so watery and it had a harsh line around the edge, and it just really wasn't fun using that kind of consistency in such a small area. So I definitely need to pop that back on my favourites and get a white. Grogu is really adorable though. On the show, his character design, he is so cute, and I wanted to do him justice, and I feel like I might have just done it with this painting. As always, I used a hairdryer to remove my tape and get a lovely straight line. I really hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and if you have, please like and subscribe to let me know. If you have any ideas for what you'd like to see me paint next, a movie or TV show, then just let me know in the comments down below, and hopefully I'll be able to include it in this series. I hope you have a lovely rest of your day, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye!